Hello, I'm Alan McGirvan. Hey, this has been a big week. This has been our 747 Qantas week. As you know, the last Qantas 747, the Queen of the Skies, took off, if you've seen our Facebook through the week, for the last time out of Sydney on the 22nd. They did an amazing thing. Have a look at this. Somehow, flight radar has seen them transcribe a perfect kangaroo off the coast of Sydney. How did they do that? So there it is, that's the last one. That's the final Qantas 747, 300 tons of sheer joy, which I was fortunate enough to fly many times. In fact, take a look at this. This is 1980 and this is me. And I'm standing in the engine nacelle of a 747 with my flight engineer buddy, John Douglas. Now, this is the aircraft we used on the Ultimate Sickie in October of 1980. The Ultimate Sickie was where everyone bought a note from their boss, paid about $100, which at the time was a bit of money, and got to fly around Queensland, out of Brisbane, right to the tip to Horn Island, then down the coast, along the Great Barrier Reef and back to Brisbane. That's 7 hours, and all proceeds went to the Royal Flying Doctor Service. And it was a classic. The Ultimate Sickie, we're going through another kind of Ultimate Sickie at the moment, and I hope you're coming through the other side. So we adapt, we overcome, and thank goodness we're getting somewhere. So have a look at this. This is, as I say, 40 years ago. It's called the Ultimate Sickie. It won the Australian Radio Promotion of the Year. And when you see it, you'll know why. We do this to celebrate Flashback Friday and Qantas 747 Week. Qantas, by the way, remain a client of ours for the last 30 years. Now, that's a good story, isn't it? Watch this.
Fully loaded jumbo jet left Brisbane for a non-stop tour of Queensland. It was the brainchild of Brisbane radio station 4IP and carried with it one of the biggest groups of sightseers, sickie sightseers, ever to see the state in one round trip. Jim Devine joined the flight to see what really goes on at 30,000 feet.
Well, I've done some fairly strange things in my time, but this has got to be one of the most unusual. In just a few minutes' time, me, along with some 400 other people, will be boarding that aircraft with Alan McGirvan from 4IP and spending the next 6 to 7 hours in the air flying all around Queensland. Now, Alan has entitled it in his own inimitable style, the Ultimate Sickie. And every one of those 400 people here today will have to have a note from the doctor to cover for them while they're taking this sickie.
How are you feeling?
Fine.
You look like you haven't had a good meal for a while. Fine.
Thank you.
Fine. I'll show you. Do you remember where to sit?
No, I don't actually.
It's up the front, just near the windscreen. Right up the very front.
Oh, well, I'll see what we can do. I've got a seat. I don't know about you.
I hope
you're feeling all right this morning, Doctor.
I hope you remember what Thursday Island looks like.
Yes, it was explained to me yesterday by our dear friend up north.
We rang Thursday Island yesterday and he explained to Ken that it's small.
It's got water all around it.
Water all around
and
it.
It's got green trees.
The green trees.
So, we hope we found it.
You know, Jim, I don't think this has ever happened anywhere in the world. You know, a sickie per se. The concept is, of course, that most of the people on board are self-employed or are on holidays or aren't working and someone's bought them the ticket. So. And genuinely, a lot of people did bring a note from their boss. It was terrific. I don't think anyone's ever done it. Qantas said that they've never had a charter quite like this. We've filled the airplane. There was an empty seat. 460 people in this jumbo.
And the people were paying $180 a time. So yeah. they obviously...
considered that they should go and see their own state as well.
Yeah, because, you know, Queensland's alike, you know, we love the state. This is unique. Queensland is the future of Australia. I believe it is. And there's a lot of very happy people on board. We're just passing over Qantas, I'm talking to you. We've just been talking, I was in the cockpit talking to an aircraft of the Royal Flying Doctor Service. And we've managed to get $5,000, just over $5,000 as our share for the Queensland Royal Flying Doctor Service, which is all, and Northern Territory as well.
Yeah.
So that's great news.
And I think that the...
I think he's going to have a heart attack.
Well, I could have a heart attack.
Another one bites the dust.
This is the best day of my life here. Definitely.
Another one bites the dust.
Yeah, now, did you have to go and explain to your boss?
I did, yes. But he said to me, John, he said, I don't mind if you go away today because we're doing reasonably well this month. And he said, you can go. So I said, beauty.
Another one bites the dust.
You know, but he's a great boss.
Another one bites the dust.
We haven't all got bosses like that, but he's a good boss.
Another one bites the dust. And another one gone, and another one gone. Another one bites the dust. Hey, hey, we're gonna get you too. Another one bites the dust.
Who's flying the plane exactly?
Well, what we did, we jammed a bit of stick in front of the joystick, and we've got a brick in the accelerator, and I hope it's going to fly pretty straight at the moment. It seems to be pretty straight now.
What I'd like to know is who's paying for these sickies? Who is paying for these sickies?
Because Malcolm Fraser has told us to go back to work.
No, well, he's told us too.
Thought I'd better mention him because not many people have got a boss like him.
We've still got the bit of wood jammed in the joystick though, and we've got the brick still in the accelerator, so we're keeping pretty well level.
Sunshine never ends, it's one big holiday. Come on, come on, to play. Share Queensland with a friend. Do you will again, it's got so much to say. Come on, come on, to play. Share Queensland with a friend. Where the sunshine never ends, it's one big holiday. Come on, come on.
And I think a lot of people are going to have to take a sickie to get over the sickie. We'll be back with some young people who don't ever want to take a sickie in their lives now that they've got a job.